Hey folks, Wayne over here at the Ram Man. We got this client's local good old boy. It's 2009. So 2009 was the first time that Dodge went to the big bearings. They went to the bigger axle, bigger shafts, bigger bearings and all that. 2009 was the first year. So on this model and newer, you do not have to change the stub shafts. We designed it so you don't have to change it. And we made this thing so simple, it is unbelievably simple. You literally unbolt your old one, slide it off, and slide the new one on. Now, people ask me, well, what about these plates? Where do they go? Well, of course they go right there. We even had to make up this sheet in the last month. We made up this sheet that shows where the spacer plate goes. And right here, we got these three arrows and the pictures, right? These show where the rotor spacers go. We actually had a client that did not know where this spacer plate went. He was telling us he was trying to put it on the front. And he was telling us that we had drilled his hub wrong and that it wouldn't go on. Now, you people think that I'm kidding. I'm not kidding. On my mama's life, he was trying to put this on the front. Sure enough, he trying to put it on the front. Yeah. We tell folks, please have some knowledge about what you're doing. We have made this so simple to do, but there's people that are still having some trouble with it. So here you go. All you gotta do is get your hub off. 5-gallon bucket helps out really well. Hold your caliper, hold your rotor assembly. It's all stuck in there. I mean, hey guys, we ship these things with these put together. I mean, they come in the box just like this. Are you with me? These are ready to put on. Right? They're just in the free mode. They're ready to put on. We got people that pull them apart, that disassemble them and pull the locking units out, and they're looking for something down in there to attach. Clips, screws, bolts, washers, cashew nuts. I don't know what they're looking for, but like what we said, this is easy. You literally slide your old hub off and slide the new one on. Now, if you look at this original Dodge hub, this lip is really shallow. It's like 3/8 of an inch. It just barely has a little lip to sit right there, this knuckle, right? Now, it's Ford design. This Ford's got this great big old giant over, that's about 800 lip right here for the support and for the bolts. Much better design. Everything's tighter, right on top of each other. It's a brilliant design. So here we've got it. ABS is always on the top. You guys know that. We've got it here in free. So, you know, here we go. It's our little thrust bushing. So we're going to grab our little hub and we're on film. Now, it's a spline gizmo, so it may take just a minute or 5 seconds to line up the splines. Let's see. Oh, well, doggone. That's how long it took, my friends. Now, I need you to understand something. We left the plate off for simplicity. The plate goes right there. But I want you to notice that I just slid this on as one piece. This is what we keep talking about. One piece assembly. Them other guys got 50 or 60 parts laid out all over a table. Hell, it looks like my marble set when it got lost on top of the table. That's what it looks like to me. You want to talk about, that's not an all-day affair. That's an all-weekend affair. That's how long it took me to get this on here. I'm going to be honest with you, folks. We have some guys been turning wrenches all their life. They've got a good floor jack. They've got air tools. They've changed these a couple times. They've had Dodges all their lives. They are putting these hubs on in 45 minutes a side. 45 minutes a side. I've got pictures of a guy with a Chevrolet, an older gentleman with a dually 3500 Chevrolet with a big old 14-foot overhead camper. He's retired. He's putting his hubs on in a Walmart parking lot. Call me a liar and I'll send you, Kate will send you the pictures. He's putting them on in a Walmart parking lot. Sure enough. Anyway, rotor spacers go right there. Keep your distance intact with your caliper and everything. This right here cuts down on your surface area. Your heat transfer from your rotor to the hub. You have to remember something. The rotor is your mass. The rotor is what soaks up that kinetic energy into thermal energy. The rotor is the mechanism, is the gizmo that is hot. And when it sits down there, this entire surface area, it's allowed to transfer this heat to the bearing and to the grease rapidly. But when you cut down the surface area, which is just like a rotor design, and you allow for air movement all across there, the whole hub, all this is just, well, it's borrowed from like NASCAR and IndyCar, where they're using new composites and stuff and spacers to cut down on the surface area, the contact surface area. The lower the surface area, the slower the heat transfer. So that helps out too. Transform your buggy, get you some locking hubs. The factory thinks that you're a fool giving everybody these spline hubs. If your tires are turning, that axle's turning, that front drive shaft is turning, and half of that transfer case is turning. That's why people got their transmissions and transfer cases are blowing up all over the United States. You don't believe me? You Google Dodge transmissions and transfer cases blowing up. You Google that stuff and call me a liar. God bless you. God bless America. And happy Moparing.